I promise you, Manfred, a most wonderful scheme. That afternoon he called upon his friend, Mr. Fair of Scotland Yard, and when the commissioner heard this request, he was less surprised than amused. I was wondering how long it would be before you wanted to see our prisons, senor, he said. I can arrange that with the commissioners. What prison would you like to see? I wish to see a typical county prison, said Leon. What about Bagsetter? Bagsetter, said the other in surprise. That's rather a long way from London. It doesn't differ very materially from Wandsworth, which is a few miles from this building, or Pentonville, which is our headquarters prison. I prefer Bagsetter, said Leon. The fact is I am going to the Devonshire coast, and I could fill in my time profitably with this inspection. The order was forthcoming on the next day. It was a printed note authorizing the governor of H.M. Prison, Bagsetter, to allow the bearer to visit the prison between the hours of 10 and 12 in the morning, and 2 and 4 in the afternoon. They broke their journey at Bagsetter, and Leon drove up to the prison, a prettier building than most of its kind. He was received by the deputy governor and a tall, good-looking chief warder, and an ex-guardsman, who showed him round the three wings and through the restricted grounds of the goal. Leon rejoined his companion on the railway station just in time to catch the Plymouth Express, which would carry them to Newton Abbot. "A thoroughly satisfactory visit," said Leon. "In fact, it is the most amazingly convenient prison I have ever been in." "Convenient to get into or convenient to get away from?" asked Manfred. "Both," said Leon. They had not engaged rooms at either of the hotels. Leon had decided, if it was possible, to get lodgings near the scene of the tragedy, and in this he was successful. 3 houses removed from the corner house where Dr. Twenden was in residence, he discovered furnished lodgings were to let. A kindly, rosy-faced Devonshire woman was the landlady, and they were the only tenants, her husband being a gunner on one of His Majesty's ships, and he was at sea.